This is Shweta. Welcome to my classes. Today we will be dealing with the electronic configuration. First, let us understand what is the definition of electronic configuration, and then we will move on to how to write the electronic configuration. So, it is the distribution of electrons in various orbitals in the increasing order of the energy. So, what it is saying that electronic configuration, we are supposed to write this for any of the elements in the periodic table, isn't it? So, what it states is that distribution of electrons, how your electrons have been arranged in various orbitals. Your orbitals are nothing but, which are those orbitals? You have S, P, D, F, isn't it? These are called as orbitals, you have already learned. So in these orbitals, how your electrons are to be filled. So how they are filled? In the increasing order of the energy. Okay, so like this, your definition of electronic configuration goes. So but you have to remember that the maximum your S orbital can accommodate how many electrons? It can accommodate 2 electrons. Maximum it can have 2, or it's less than 2, but never more than 2. And here for P, how many electrons? Maximum of 6 electrons. What you are going to do here? You have to do plus 4 for this. Okay? So it will be 6. It will be like only 6 electrons or less than that. Never more than that. And for D, how many electrons? Maximum of 10 electrons. Again, you are supposed to do plus 4 here. So D orbital will have maximum of 10 electrons, or else less than that, but never more than that. Okay, again F orbital, again you do plus 4 here, it will be like 14 electrons. So maximum it can accommodate 14 electrons. So this you should be knowing to write the electronic configuration. So now how to determine the energy? So here the Aufbau principle gave the principle for writing the electronic configuration. What does it say is that the electrons enter into the atomic orbitals in the increasing order of the energy. He said how the electrons are to be filled in the orbitals. So always he said that in the increasing order means first the the orbital which is having lesser energy should be filled first and then greater energy. So on he gave the principle. Okay. So what does he state is that, so according to this now, how to determine the increasing order of the energy means like N plus L rule. So this is what? N plus L rule. So here N is what? Your principal quantum number and L is your azimuthal quantum number. So among by applying this now you will get the value. So for two orbitals are given, you think, if two orbitals are given, you have to find the N plus L rule. If the value, the orbital which is having higher value is having more energy. So if it is having higher value, then more energy. If it has higher value, then it implies that it is having more energy. If it is having lower value, then it is less energy. Like this, using N plus L rule, we are going to compare. So think that if N plus rule for two orbitals, it is coming same. If both are coming same, then N. So which is having N now? If N is greater, then that will have the more energy. So if in case if both the N plus L values are greater, this is Aufbau's principle. So based on N plus L rule now, this increasing order of the energy diagram is plotted. Like this 1 to 7s orbitals you are going to write, then like 1p orbital will not be there, 2 to 7p you are going to write. And 3d orbital will not be there, so you are going to start from 3. And similarly, 4 like the 3f orbital will not be there, you are going to start from 4. So this is the easiest way to find the electronic configuration. So you have to write the diagram like this. So what you are supposed to do now? So you are supposed to find the increasing order. You can see the curve here. So first lowest energy is 1s. So it is going like this. And then follow this dotted line and come for the solid line. It will be 2s. And then we have to go for 2p. And then 3s. And then you should not come for 3s after 3p and then 4s. After 3p you should not go for 3d. So you should come for 4s. And then we have to go for 3d, 4p, 5s and then 4d. So similarly go on, it is in the increasing order of the energy. Like this your electrons go on filling. So how your increasing order of energy is? First is your 1s, next is your 2s, next is your 2p, next is 3s, after 2p 3s, after 3s 3p and 4s. It will be 3p and 4s, and then after 3p 4s what you are supposed to write? You are supposed to write 3d 4p, 3d 4p, 3d 4p 5s. So like this you are supposed to fill the electrons. So now this is with the least energy, that your energy is going on increasing. Like this you have to fill the electronic configuration. So now we will write the electronic configuration of elements from 1 to 10 atomic numbers. So here Z is nothing but atomic number I have written 1 to 10. We will write the element and also electronic configuration using this increasing order of the energy diagram. So first element is what, you know that it is hydrogen, isn't it? So first the electron should go in the least lower energy orbital, that is 1s. So I will write here 1s, but your atomic number is 1. So electron. So here it will be 1s. So this is 1s. Clear? And then next is what? Atomic number 2, it will be helium. So similarly, again you are going to suppose to fill the electrons in first orbital. That is 1s, but 2 electrons are there, isn't it? So I have to fill both electrons in s orbital. You know that maximum s can accommodate 2 electrons. You have to remember this. S can accommodate 2, p can accommodate 6, d can accommodate 10, and f can accommodate 14. Okay. And next, coming to the third element, it is lithium. It is lithium. So here again 1s and 2s you have to consider. So 1s 2 will be filled and 2s. But since there are 3 electrons, so 2 and s you will have 1. So 2 plus 1 will be 3. This fills your lithium. Next 4 is what? It is beryllium. So again what you are supposed to do? Again 1s and 2s are the lower orbitals. In the increasing order 1s 2 is filled. 2s 2 is also filled. Clear? S can accommodate maximum of 2 electrons. Clear? It will be 4. And then fifth is what? The fifth element is boron. Clear? Again this will be same. 4 electrons. 1s2, 2s2 will be same. After see 1s2, 2s2. After that next is your 2p. So your 2p will come, but only 1 electron is to be filled. So it will be boron. Okay. Next is what? Your carbon. So again this pi will be same. Okay. That is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p. Since your p orbital can fill maximum of 6 electrons, so 1 plus again 1 you can add in this one. So it will be 2p2. And then 7 is what? Your nitrogen. So this will be again same 1s2, 2s2, but 2p. Again p has the maximum capability of 6. So again another electron can be filled here only. Isn't it? So it will be 3. Clear? Next 8 is what? Your oxygen. So your 1s2, 2s2, 2p. Again it can fill another electron. Okay, till 6 is the capability, isn't it? 2p4. Then your 9 is your fluorine, isn't it? So again 1s2, 2s2, and I can write 2p5 here. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Why? Because still it has another electron to be filled, isn't it? So maximum capability is 6. So next last 10 is your neon. So neon is what? 1s2, 2s2, and 2p6. 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2 is 10. So you can see maximum capability is 6. More than this I cannot fill. So up till here. Clear? This is the way to find fill the electronic configuration. Next we'll move on to this atomic number 11. You know that it is sodium. So again we will start writing. It will be 1s2, 2s2, next 2p6, and then 3s. How many electrons to be filled? So here you have already seen that 6 plus 2 is 10, 10 plus sorry, 6 plus 2 is 8, 8, 10 is there. Okay, you want 11. So 3s, 1. So next is, after 2p it will be 3s, isn't it? But we want only 1 electron, so it is to be filled. So here maximum is 6 electrons, isn't it? When it is completely filled, you have to move on to the next orbital. So next is what? Your atomic number 12 is magnesium. So here also, like this will be same. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Up till here it was 10, isn't it? So it is 11, so it can accommodate 2. So it will be 12, isn't it? That is the electronic configuration of magnesium. Next 13 is what? 13 is your aluminium. So aluminium, how are you supposed to write? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 is now completely filled, isn't it? So after 3s2, where are you supposed to go? You're supposed to go 3p, isn't it? So 3p, so only one electron needs to be filled. So it will be 3p1. Clear? And next is what? 14. 14 is what? Your silicon. So this rest will be same. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Up till here it will be 12, isn't it? So here p can accommodate till 6 electrons. So it will be 3p2. This is of silicon. Next is 15 is what? Your phosphorus. So 15, again p only can accommodate, isn't it? This rest will be same. 2p6, 3s2. Here 1 you have to add. That is 3p3. It will be 15. Clear? And next 16 is your sulfur. Again this will be same. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Here 3p4 you can write. Just 1 you have to increase. So here p can accommodate 6 electrons. You know that. Clear? Next we are going to 17. 17 you know that it is chlorine. Isn't it? So again this will be same. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. And here it will be 3p5. Clear? This will be of chlorine. And then 18 is what? Your argon. Okay, your noble gas. So here 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, and it will be 3p6. Now it is completely filled. 19 is what? Your potassium, isn't it? So here this will be same. Till 18 you have to write same. Argon's configuration only it will be, isn't it? 3p3s2, 3p6. Now after 3p orbital which will come, see, after 3p you have 4s orbital. So it will be 4s orbital. But since this was already 18, isn't it? So now you are supposed to fill only one electron here. So it will be 4s1. Clear? And then 20 is what? Your calcium. So calcium, again this will be same. Till argon configuration you have to write same. 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Now it will be 4s2. So because s can accommodate 2 electrons, so in that orbital only we are filling again one electron. So here in this, now while writing electronic configuration, 2 exceptions are there, like chromium and copper. So within up to atomic number 30 when you come across, these 2 are the exceptions you can say. So for chromium, that is atomic number is 24. So here already it is 18, isn't it? So here 5 plus 1, 6 orbitals will be remaining. But you see, first is 3D, isn't it? So first will be your 4s orbital. Here you see, your 4s orbital is first. After complete fill of 4s, you should go to 3D. But here what it is happening? So here the s electron from 4s, now one electron is getting jumped to 3D orbital. Why? Because to gain the extra stability of half filled. Now they both are half filled, isn't it? So to gain this extra stability of half filled, this is the exception here. Similarly, copper atomic number 29. Here argon I have written it is totally 18. Okay, so 18 your remaining will be like 11 electrons. So how they are filled? Again, it should be first filled in 4s only. Here also one electron will jump from 4s orbital to 3D orbital to gain the full stability here. Means fully orbital, completely filled orbital stability we can say. So these 2 are the exceptions up till the atomic number 30. I hope you understood how to write the electronic configuration. If you are new to the channel, please do subscribe and tap the bell icon for notification. Thank you.